In this tutorial, I'll show you how to create motion timelines in Choregraphe. First, we need to understand how motions are represented as an object in a behavior. For this, we drag an existing motion box called Hello from the Motion Animation Box library. Set it up to start at the launch of the behavior and upload to the virtual robot. When the motion hello is executed, we can see that the robot raises and waves its right arm. At the same time, it turns its face slightly to the right. So, how is this motion composed? Let's stop the behavior and double-click the hello box. This brings up something that looks like a time scale in the upper portion of the window. This is called a timeline. The numbers on the timeline represent units of time. Now, these are not absolute units of time, but indicate time in a relative sense. This will be explained later. On the timeline, we see gray markers. They are called keyframes. Each keyframe actually represents a pose. For example, the first keyframe is the pose you see on the right. The robot has slightly raised its right arm and slightly turned its face. As I click on the second keyframe, we see the robot in a second pose, a slightly higher right arm. Then a third, a fourth, a fifth, and so on. It is now obvious that the hello motion that you saw a while ago is composed of several keyframes, about 20 of them. Each keyframe represents the pose at a certain point in time. When the robot executes this entire motion sequence, what happens is that an internal simulator produces a smooth transition from one keyframe to the next, so that the entire motion looks continuous. Now, we wish to change part of motion. For example, take this keyframe here. In this pose, the right arm is raised, while the left arm is around waist height. Suppose we want the robot to raise its left arm a little higher. How to do that? First, double-click the left arm in the robot view, which brings up the motion window. In this window, we see an animated model of the left arm, showing the joint angles of the arm. We can slide the scroll bar for each of the six joints to change the pose for the keyframe. For example, let's raise the arm. To do this, we shall modify this joint, the left shoulder pitch joint, shown in green. Currently, this joint angle is 53.5 degrees. Slide the bar and watch how the arm moves in the robot view above. Let's set the joint angle at minus 50.8 degrees. As you can see, the left arm is raised. Or set it at zero. Now the arm is at shoulder height. Let's replay this motion by clicking the play button left of the timeline. You can see the left arm raised up when the replay hits the keyframe we have just modified. However, you might find that the left arm motion is a little bit abrupt. To make it more gradual up and down motion, we can consider modifying the neighboring keyframes also. Let's reset the left arm in the previous keyframe to plus 30 degrees. Then make the left arm go to zero in the next keyframe. In the following keyframe, the left arm should be on its way down. So let's set it to, say, plus 40 degrees. Replay. As you can see, now the up and down motion of the left arm is smoother. With that, you can imagine changing other keyframes in an existing timeline to produce the motion you want. Another way to compose a motion is to start with a blank timeline. You can find the timeline box in the templates library. Drag it into your behavior. Double-click to open the timeline. You now see a blank timeline, that is, it produces no motion. The first thing to do is to decide how much time your motion will take. Let's make it 60. So at the number 60, right-click and choose Set and Frame here. There, we've just defined a motion that lasts 60 units of time. Suppose we want the robot to start from the pose you see on the right, then stoop down by bending its knees, and then return to the initial pose. First, let's make a copy of the current pose in the timeline. Right-click the beginning of the timeline, choose Store Joints in Keyframe, choose Whole Body. So the current joint values of the entire body are now stored in the first keyframe at the start of the motion. Similarly, we want the robot to return to this pose at the end of the motion. Simply copy the first keyframe and paste it at the end of the timeline. If we replay the motion, you can see that nothing happens because the initial and end poses are identical and the robot is already in this pose. Let's define a half-stooping pose at time 30. Such a pose is essentially produced by the hip and knee joints, and also the ankle. Let's start with the right leg. Here we have the joints of the right leg. First, set this hip joint to minus 85 degrees. Next, bend the knees to about 82 degrees. For the robot to stoop like this, we should also adjust the ankle joint to, say, minus 20 degrees. We have just completed the right leg and should do the left leg. Since the left leg should be symmetrical to the right, we use a convenient feature here. Right-click on the newly created keyframe, go down to Mirror and choose Selected Key, meaning this key alone. Then choose Right to Left, because we want to make the left leg mirror the right one. Replay. That's precisely a half-stooping pose. Suppose in addition that we want to raise both arms in this pose. Start with the right arm. Let's adjust the right shoulder. Mirror right to left again. The arms are now symmetrical. Now, we can notice vaguely a chair appear behind the robot. This actually indicates that there is a risk of falling if the robot gets into this pose. From this angle, we can see that the robot is probably leaning too much forward. Let's adjust the leg joints. Right, the chair is gone, meaning that the adjusted pose has a lower risk of falling. It is safer than the earlier one. Let's replay. Okay, as expected, the robot starts from the initial pose, stoops and raises its arms, then returns to the initial pose. So remember that if the chair appears, it means that there is a risk of falling. Before you upload any timeline to the physical robot, make sure that the chair does not appear throughout. Next, I want to show you a design detail. Currently, we see that the robot executes the motion rather quickly. If you want to slow it down, we can simply click this button. It says Timeline Properties. In the pop-up, we see the line frames per second. Right now, it is set at 25. What it really means is that the numbers you see above the timeline are actually numbers of frames. If 25 frames correspond to 1 second in real time, then it takes 2 seconds plus to complete 60 frames. Let's reduce the frame rate to 15. So 60 frames now take 4 seconds. The motion becomes slower as the replay shows. We can even reduce the frame rate to 5 FPS. Then it'll be much slower. Right. Looks like that's too slow. Let's set it at 10 FPS. So the robot takes 6 seconds to execute this motion. We have finished composing our motion. Return to the root level. Finally, we can customize this box. For example, change the name of the box. Say, flex knees. Also, put in our own description instead of the default. This completes the programming of a timeline motion. You can include this box in a behavior or just make this stand alone. As you can see, it is not difficult to compose a timeline. Here, I have expanded the earlier motion by adding more keyframes. Try and see if you can do something similar or even fancier. Goodbye.